Incoming Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles says high engagement and number of followers may be used as basis for the possible accreditation of vloggers to cover Malacañang. Angeles says they are currently reviewing an existing policy on vlogger accreditation, which she said was put in place during the Duterte administration. She adds their main focus is to determine if vloggers would be allowed to attend regular palace briefings.
Hindi pa rin natin po alam kung tama na nga po ngayon ang panahon na nararapat para ma-include sila, ano yung level of inclusion, ano yung number of, kumbaga, will they be regular like the similar to the Malacañang Press Corps, mm-hmm. or will they just be able to cover events? Do we create events for them? Right now, tinitignan din po namin yung engagements, kasi engagements really means that people are responding to what you have written or shown in the case of vloggers, no? Na at interesado sila or nai-involve sila dun sa sinasabi. So ngayon, ang kinukonsider namin both following and engagements kasi magkaiba po yung...
Vloggers played a huge role during the campaign of President-elect Bongbong Marcos, with some given priority access during UNITEAM sorties. Motorists again call on government to suspend the excise tax on fuel as oil prices continue to soar. Let's hear more from Evelyn at Chico.
As fuel prices rose, worker Janelle has started to use his bicycle and decided to temporarily retire his motorcycle to minimize expenses.
Tambay muna sa bahay kasi mahal yung gasolina ngayon eh. Mahirap yung buhay. Noong dati kasi magkano lang yun, nasa 50 lang yun eh, 53. Ngayon, wala, tumaas na ngayon. Magkano na ngayon ng 78 na ngayon? Mahirap ang buhay.
Gasoline now retails at 74 to 97 pesos per liter, while diesel is at 75 pesos to 90 pesos in Metro Manila. Bayan patrollers have also sent fuel prices in their areas where fuel now costs more than 80 pesos per liter. In Palawan, prices are now more than 90 pesos per liter. Motorists are asking the government to consider suspending the excise tax on petroleum.
Sana iano nila yung excise tax ng petrolyo para kahit paano matulungan yung mga katulad naming motorista.
Kung makakatulong sa pangkalahatan, eh, okay lang po.
Mas okay po yung tanggalin muna yung tax para habang wala pa, at least mababa yung konsumo ng namin.
Removing excise tax means a slash of 10 pesos per liter for gasoline, 6 pesos for diesel, and 5 pesos for kerosene. If government decides to suspend the biofuels component of fuel, gasoline will be cheaper by 3 to 4 pesos per liter and diesel by 1 to 2 pesos per liter. But incoming Senate Ways and Means Committee Chairman Sherwin Gatchalian says it is better to increase the targeted help to the transport sector.
Kahit doblehin pa natin yan to about 6 billion, mas mura pa rin siya kaysa mawala yung 200 billion plus. So para sa akin, yan ang mas epesyente pa. Pero hindi ko rin sinasarayin isip ko sa pagtatanggal ng excise tax, Alvin, lalo na kung humaba itong gera.
Gatchalian is not in favor of raising income tax, but is studying the possibility of raising taxes on non-essential goods and services. The senator says the BIR should resolve collection efficiency issues, but when asked if the tax bureau should collect the tax on the Marcos estate, Gatchalian insists the issue is political.
Political ploy nga yung narrative na yun eh, no? Lumabas lang nung politika eh. Obviously, political story ang politika at pang-politika lang yun. Makikita ko natin, lumabas pa yan sa mga katunggaling kandidato. No? At kung mayroong ganyan nga, dapat lumabas sa bibig ng BIR yan, lumabas sa bibig ng DOF.
Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez earlier said the government is bent on collecting any tax due on the Marcos estate. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.
Unlike outgoing Agrarian Reform Secretary Bernie Cruz, the next DAR chief believes it is not possible to bring down rice prices to 20 pesos per kilo anytime soon. Our correspondent Lady Vicentia now joins us with details. Lady, what else did the Congressman Conrado Estrella III say?
Fermina, incoming Agrarian Reform Chief Representative Conrado is not yet confident it's possible to bring the price down to 20 pesos per kilo. In contrast to the statement in Secretary Bernie Cruz, this could materialize as early as 2023. But Australia says this needs to be further studied with a continuous hike in oil and fertilizer prices. He believes 27 to 28 pesos per kilo price is more feasible with the current situation. Australia also clarifies elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. did not commit to lower prices to 20 pesos. Rather, this is an aspiration and that he continues to be realistic about it. The newly appointed DAR chief recognizes the pressure in following the footsteps of his grandfather, Conrado Estrella Sr., who was the first agrarian reform secretary under the Marcos dictatorship. To boost the local production, the use of rice seeds, modern technology and soil analysis is key for Australia, but he sees it will be challenging to convince farmers to be open to new ideas. Under his leadership, Australia aims for the department to be able to provide land titles to agrarian reform beneficiaries, aside from providing a certificate of land ownership award. He also plans to hire a data scientist to help him with the research needed to run the department. That's the latest from our end. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Lady Vicentia. They're joining us on the line.